טוב, תודה השם. So we're learning הלכות, תודה השם today. זה הלכה, תף קוף פי דלד, שולחן אורך, אור החיים, 584. כן? על ראש השנה, we do not say הלל. Neither on יום הכיפורים. Why don't we say הלל? Every חג we say הלל. The reason why we don't say הלל is because why don't we say Hallel? We don't say Hallel because it's day of judgment. Hashem is judging us. So even though we're batuach that Hashem is not Hashem, we're going to be yotze zakai badin, and there'll be no problems. But still, it's a day of judgment. When you go to court, you don't dance and sing unless you're a Berland. Then you can dance and sing wherever. But most people have to be, you're in court, you have to be serious. So that's why we don't say Hallel on Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippurim. Okay? And there's a minag to say, at least by Ashkenazim, to say Avinu Malkenu from Rosh Hashanah until after Yom Kippurim. Unless Rosh Hashanah is on Shabbat, and we don't say Avinu Malkenu on Shabbat. And Yom Kippur, if it's Yom Kippur is on Shabbat, we don't say Avinu Malkenu, only in Neila. The last prayer, the fifth prayer of Yom Kippur, will say, Avinu Malkenu. Otherwise, we don't say. Now, on Rosh Hashanah, there's an inyan to the prayers to lengthen until after Chatzot of the day. Now, usually on Shabbos, or on Yom Tov, it's asur. It's a problem. Why? Because a person, you're not allowed to fast on Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. I'm sorry, Yom Kippur, you have to fast. But on Rosh Hashanah, on a Chag, you're not supposed to fast. On Shabbos, you're not supposed to fast. And fasting half a day is considered already a fast. But since Rosh Hashanah is the day of judgment, so therefore, even if it falls on Shabbos, if a person is strong enough, especially on the first day, which is Din HaKashya, it's more of judgment that day, he should make an effort to fast until after Chatzot, until after davening. So, if it's after Chatzot, it's after Chatzot, lo nora. And not to eat before the tkiot, not to eat, only after Musaf to go make Kiddush. If a person, it's hard for him, or he's not able to, or you know, if he, now he sits, now he does that, Gamana with his prayers, he cannot focus, he might faint, he might be dizzy, he might this. So he doesn't have to wait so long. He'll wait till after Kriyat Torah, till after Shacharit. Usually there's a break and many shuls, and they'll sit and eat. But the chatchila to go and sin and eat, right? To have kiddush lechatchila, oh, why not? Kacha. On Rosh Hashanah, before the tkiot, it's not a big lechatchila. It's not so big. On the first day especially. Yeah, but don't go and judge anyone. You don't know what's going on by people. You don't know anything. I'm just talking about each one for himself. Okay? If you're able the first day of Rosh Hashanah to go with the tefillah until the end, you should. Without eating. Very good. The prayer, the Kriyat HaTorah that we read on Rosh Hashanah, okay? We read, V'Hashem pakad et tzarak asher amar, we talk about, talks about over there, the portion of the Torah, that Hashem pakad et tzarak, Sarah was barren, and on Rosh Hashanah, she got pregnant. כן? And also Chana, the mother of Shmuel HaNavi also. So therefore we read these portions of the Torah and the prophets. We read it on Rosh Hashanah. And also we also read the portion of the Torah, the Akedat Yitzchak. How do you say in English? I don't know. But when you put Yitzchak Avinu on the altar to sacrifice him, right? Why do we read that? To remind Hashem that look at the Mesirut Nefesh that Yitzhak Avinu did and for you, and also to give us the power. Please have mercy on us, Zat Hashem. Okay. How many people get an Aliyah on Rosh Hashanah? Just like any other Chag, five aliyot and a maftir. It goes like this. On a regular Monday, Thursday, is three aliyot. Kohen, Levi, and Israel. Three people are called up to the Torah. On Rosh Chodesh and on Chol HaMoed, four people are called up to the Torah. On Chag, five people are called to the Torah. On Yom Kippur, which is higher than the Chag, six people are called to the Torah. And on Shabbat, which is the highest of all days, it's Shabbat, seven people are called to the Torah. You could call more than that, but it's a minimum of. Minimum of. Okay? And some shuls, the minhag is to do it in every day. And people know, so they don't go daven in the minyan if they don't. Let's say they have a simcha, so fine, then they're happy. If you do too many times, it's ticha de tzibura, it's not nice. So a lot of times they add one or two or three, or if it's a big simcha, whatever. Some shul, in the breast of shul Yerushalayim, the big breast of shul, and the second minyan. Every Shabbos is many smachot. It's a big minyan, Baruch Hashem. And you know that if you go there for the Kriyat Torah, so the Kriyat Torah takes like the Shachrit and Musaf together. It's very long. So you know that ahead of time, so you don't go. You go to the next minyan, and then that's there they keep it regular. The prayers are amazing, but the Kriyat Torah, it should be just flowing. Fine. If there's a brit, okay, if there's a brit on, once again before that, I wanted to say that there's a minag that the Baal Tokea, the person who blows the shofar on Rosh Hashanah, he gets an aliyah in the shul, and also the Baal Tefillah. Baal Tefillah of Musaf. Okay. Now, if there's a brit on Rosh Hashanah, when do you do the brit? So Shulchan Aruch says, Malin ben Kirat HaTorah et Kiat Shofar. Make a brit between Kirat HaTorah and blowing the shofar, reading the Torah and blowing the shofar. Okay. It's very special that you do it right before Tkiat Shofar. What's the whole idea behind? Why do we do the Tkiat Shofar on Rosh Hashanah? What's the idea behind it? Besides the fact that Torah commanded us. The idea behind it, we use a shofar from a ram. Because Avraham Avinu, he was willing to sacrifice his son Yitzchak, and Yitzchak was willing to be sacrificed. And instead, Hashem told him to take him off and put the ram instead. So the ram is the connected, the shofar, the horn of the ram, is to remind the Kivechol HaKadosh Baruch Hu of their will to serve Hashem, Mesirut Nefesh. So also when you do a brit, it's also to remind the Kodesh Baruch Hu together, it works together. First of all, when he did the brit, then he had a son, and then he sacrificed him. Okay, so that was the order of the things. So therefore, we do the brit then. I have a brother whose brit was on Rosh Hashanah. No. And once again, that's the second year. The Gra brings down that. Yeah, and then it brings down the second thing. The Mishabur brings down the Gra. Mila is more common than blowing the shofar, and therefore it's.
As the Torah.
As the Torah, right. Torah. All the time, yeah, every three times a week, at least. Yeah. Now, that's all. Very good and well. If the bris, if the bris is in the shul, but if it's on Shabbos, okay, and there's no eruv, so you can't carry the baby to the shul. So we're gonna tell, make everyone walk to the house where the bris is and make a bris in one back. No, then you can do the bris after davening. But if you're in Uman or in Eretz Israel, in most places a good eruv, you can bring the baby to shul. The weather is okay in all places in the world at that season. It's between seasons. It's more or less okay. So then you do the brit. In the shul. So you do it before, after Kriyat HaTorah, before blowing the shofar. I have a brother be 19 now, so he had the brit on Rosh Hashanah, about a week before Rosh Hashanah. And so this was the halacha for today. Tomorrow we'll learn more halacha.